Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series, hopefully anyway. 36 in a row. It went well last time. We had that neat new synergy to explore, and here's your seed today. It's gonna be Lima, Juliet, Bravo 9, Juliet 8, Whiskey, Whiskey. We've got slightly above average damage, decent tears rate, not great movement speed, not great range. Terrible shot speed. We've also got Blood Rites and the Mind. Along with a Wheel of Fortune card for some reason. The Mind will basically give us the map compass effect, ensuring me that unless barring Curse of the Lost, we will not run into our Sinvicta dead end scenario, thankfully. Much to the chagrin of everyone, because I know that that's everyone's favorite subject for me to talk about. So, this is not bad. I mean, it could be better. Blood Rites, of course, if we end up getting Isaac's Heart in the rare opportunity of showing the god combo that is, you know, we could be in for a very fun run. We get Virgo. Virgo is going to give us a damage shield every now and then whenever we take damage, but more importantly, it gives us neutral or positive effects on our pills, which is very, very good. I know a lot of people have been missing me taking pills lately, and I don't know what you're expecting, because I haven't taken pills in years. Secondly, yeah. Makes you small. Not exactly the best situation there. I am going to use the Wheel of Fortune card along with our bomb, and we're able to get our bomb back. Oh my goodness, we get Transcendence. And we get a golden key too. That is beautiful. So Transcendence is going to allow us to fly. Obviously that's a big time get for us. I'm actually going to take a gamble here. See, I was sort of hoping that it wasn't going to go down that way, because obviously we need two bombs to go into that bedroom over there that we started in. But it is what it is. Didn't quite happen out that way. That's okay. Transcendence gives us a huge leg up on the competition because we're able to fly this early on. The golden key. Well, now we need two bombs because I'm an idiot. So two of diamonds is going to double our money. But unfortunately, I accidentally hit the E key with my index finger, and that's going to stop us from going anywhere for the rest of this run. Well, not the rest of this run, but the rest of this floor anyway. Two of diamonds, very happy to have that. That opens up another world of possibilities for us, because if we do get blank card, at least we can get some sort of infinite money situation brewing. Got the molly booms, not too worried about the molly booms. Know exactly where the secret room is as well because of the mine, but don't have any bombs, so shout out to me and my not so magic finger. Don't take that out of context, by the way. So we get Brown Littlehorn, which is the worst of the Littlehorns, not only because of the fact that he shoots out the flaming bombs, but also, more importantly, that the flaming bombs that he does shoot do deal contact damage, which means that you have to have... You gotta be on top of your game. Now, luckily, he did nuke himself with his own fire, but unfortunately, we got a pretty much useless item, so head on down to the next floor. Eesh, not a great start. Outside of Transcendence, we're looking for help here. A little bit of a risk for me coming in here to go after a boss. It could have been anything from Super Sloth to Ultra Pride, which would have been terrible. And this room is actually pretty nasty for us to go up against Sloth. Or really any mini-boss room, just because of how small it is. You're seeing the disadvantage of us having no movement speed right now. Yo, Sloth, you gotta calm down, bro. Very tempted to use Blood Rites here just to end this fight, but didn't have to, thankfully. The World card, pretty much the most useless card for us right now, since we already have the Mind. Okay, alright, let's slow it down here. Let's just take a chill pill. I'm not going to use our only bomb for the secret room, because there's something like this, where we could get a Tinted Rock, which I am very, 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 very motivated to get. Also, thank goodness for Virgo. Virgo saving us not only from a possible lethal shot from the champion, but also preserving our deal with the devil chance anyway. Spike looked like he got a little bit stuck there on the fire. We're just going to ignore that. We need some help right now. We're not in the greatest of positions here. But at least that last room shows you the importance of making sure that you're sort of making wiser decisions when it comes to the strategy of Isaac. You know, you have one bomb. It's like, yeah, we know the secret room is and super secret room is, but what are the chances that we can get anything that helps us right now out of those rooms? We gotta live long enough to get to those rooms before they can help us, sort of mentality. Rotten Baby, of course, is going to be a huge pickup for us. The best item that we've gotten outside of Transcendence so far, anyway. Okay, I do not appreciate nor trust the angle that those brown spikes are coming in on. There we go. Let's try that again. So with these flies, you can actually manipulate them to go into the fire if you're able to. Unfortunately, we're sort of at a bad angle for this. Also, our movement speed's not quite there yet. But the Two of Diamonds, like I said, is going to provide us with a big opportunity here. Especially after getting that dime. So we've got the makings of a seam here. We're not out of the woods yet. It all comes down to what we get out of the second boss and if we end up getting a good deal with the devil or not. I'm not ready to go into the store quite yet. Did that Diglett just disappear? Yeah, I guess it just disappeared. Alright. Wow, we get a random soul heart from a regular steel chest, and I'm fine with that. Unicorn poop right there on top of doing that cute sound effect, and the rainbow unicorn effect also gives you a full heal for red hearts. In case you did not know what that does, now you do. Oh man, a golden bomb here is beautiful. Alright, so we now have a really good opportunity to catch up in this run. Take it for that last floor, which was not disastrous, but also wasn't the greatest. Alright, so we're going to go into the store. We're not going to use our only key for it, because we could bomb our way in via the secret room. And given the fact that we do have we have infinite bombs here, we don't have to worry about it. Justice is great. I was not singing Metallica's Injustice for All right there, just for the record. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're not going to take Pandora's Box. I realize this might seem silly. The reason why is because we're looking for Blank Card right now. I don't want to use up our Two of Diamonds until we find Blank Card. Now, the reason why, although Sack of Sacks is pretty tempting here. I'm not going to take it, though. Yeah, so we did not get Blank Card, unfortunately. Now, you might be wondering how come I didn't take Sack of Sacks. Basically, it comes down to the fact that Sack of Sacks tends to slow down runs. And it's not... That's not bred out of anything other than the fact that it slows you down because you have to stop and get the sacks that drop every single time. I'm not saying Sack of Sacks are bad. In fact, it's one of my favorite items. Just, I don't really want it right now. But the reason why we're looking for Blank Card, obviously, is because we have Blank Card, Two of Diamonds. We don't have to worry about money for the rest of the game. So when we get Death's List and Sin Robes, I will take Sin Robes. I'm going to leave Death's List, head on down to the next floor. I didn't want to take Death's List because there's other Devil Deal items that we could get that's possibly better. And on top of that, I don't want to be totally on Soul Heart HP quite yet. We're still not strong enough to really handle losing 3 Soul Hearts per deal with the Devil chance that we get. But Sin Robes, of course, going to be a big damage up for us. It also gives us a nice healthy amount of Soul Hearts. Which, of course, in turn also helps us with our Rotten Baby damage, which is also very good. And unfortunately, we get a useless trinket out of that. We haven't been getting the best of items for these drops here, but it's hard to complain when you've got early flying, especially Transcendence, which is a very rare item. Now, arguably, Transcendence is the worst of the flying items because you don't gain any other benefit other than just flying, as opposed to something like, say, Spirit of the Night, which gives you Spectral Tears and flying. You don't gain that with Transcendence. You basically gain nothing out of that. Very happy that we got that we have Rotten Baby, though. Rotten Baby, like I said, is going to be instrumental in our early game DPS, plus our survivability. Earthrow Rune would be awesome, and we got that. So I am going to use the Two of Diamonds here. You might think that's a little bit of a waste. I could have used Perthrow Comeback and gotten and have retrieved our Two of Diamonds card, but at this point, if we get Blank Card, I'm sure we'll probably see another Two of Diamonds. But it's to the point now in the mid-game where we don't really have to worry too much about money, especially if we're not going to plan on going to the Hush anytime soon. Another luck upgrade. Stone chest. Would have been nice if the bat flies would have stuck around there, but that's alright. Get our bomb back, so not going to complain there. And we are going to use our only key to go into the store first. Reason being is because the logic here is that, maybe we'll be able to get a key out of this. Steam sale, of course, is going to be a very big pickup for us. We'll take the coupon because we have enough full charges here to really go ham. Bombs are key. Well, that's sort of... That sort of screwed me up a little bit there, game. I'm not gonna lie. Alright, well. Alright. Try that again, shall we? Get our bomb. I will take the bomb. I'm not gonna use any more money right now, because I don't want to. Buddy in a box wouldn't really do much for us. Alright, and we go back to getting the map again. Alright. So I picked up the full charge here, not by mistake. I want to make sure that we have it for the boss. And the reason being is that if we do get a deal with the devil, which is not a very good chance, but if we do, we have a chance of getting it for free, thanks to the coupon. Of course, we get fairy bombs as well, or glitter bombs. They're pink and sparkly, and also apparently I'm terrible at laying bombs. But what glitter bombs will do is it will every now and then periodically spawn a random consumable item out of every bomb that you lay. It's not guaranteed, but it's every now and then. So this is gonna be a good room for us, I hope. We get 4 hour energy, that's very good. Something's wrong. Pheromones. Drowsy. And I found pills. Way to go. So if you're wondering why I never ever take pills ever, that's a really good showing there, because normally you don't get anything good out of taking pills, regardless if you think you do. Even if you have PhD or something like that, the neutral effects are just abound in the game. I mean, there's so many bad effects. Wow, that was right on top of us. I'm being a little bit greedy here with the fairy bombs play. Wow. Got a golden key out of that, and we did not get a deal with the devil, which I'm very, very sad about. I'm going to actually save the Perthrow. I don't mind taking the range here, but our damage is really going to start tapering off here pretty badly if we don't get something soon. So this is a big floor for us. We need to not get Krampus, and we need to also not get a deal with the devil here. Because there's only so much flying and Rotten Babe you're going to be able to carry for us before we're going to start getting bogged down by the increased amount of HP that these enemies have down in the mid-game. And I know that this episode has been a little bit more analytical than usual, but gotta focus. We don't want to lose any runs right now. Virgo Shield kicking in. I would love a movement speed upgrade. If we can get Blood Bag, that'd be awesome. We got a little bit of money there. Of course, I am going to go into the store, but first I just want to see, by store I mean the secret room. We'll see if we can get like a golden bomb or a golden key or something out of this room. Didn't happen, that's alright. And we get the Book of Revelations, which would give us the win. But is it better than the coupon for us? That's a toughie. Double our bombs back, I'm happy about that. Man. Let's use the coupon on this floor for the store and for the devil deal if we need to, and then we'll probably leave with the Book of Revelations, because this is not a bad... The movement speed that we have here is terrible, but it's not that bad if we had an orbital, especially a good one. So we get Mama Mega, which I will be buying and using. In fact, I'm just going to use it right now. If you're wondering why I didn't use the coupon there, you would be right. It was a 1 in, like, what, 5-6 chance that we could get it there, but, yeah, not worried about it. So what Mama Mega is going to do is it's going to do that huge explosion, like that. It's going to open up extra doors. It will kill everything in the room except bosses, usually. Batwing, I mean, her, I guess. So there's no real reason for us not to do a full clear on this room, or this floor, because Mama Mega is going to make it easy on us, like that. And we will go inside of the cursed room to see what's going on in there. Now, something else that you can do with Mama Mega, you can actually use Mama Mega to open up the boss rush room. Even if you miss boss rush, you can still open it up with the explosion. That's how powerful Mama Mega is. I do think that the Book of Revelations is the correct play here. I don't quite trust our movement speed, and I certainly don't trust our damage right now. Meaning that I want to make sure that, you know, if we don't have If we don't have the advantage of damage, then I want to have the advantage of us being able to produce HP for ourselves. That makes sense. I'll take this key. Okay, so what we're hoping for is we're hoping for a good deal with the devil that we can also roll with Perthrow. And then we can use the coupon to save ourselves a lot of HP on one. Alright, we did get a deal with the devil. We got cube meat, which is great. Not Krampus. It's actually the Book of Sin, which is not that great for us. I am going to use the coupon here. And we're hoping Perthrow can do us one better. We get Guppy's Paw, which is acceptable, but not what I was looking for. But at least it's a free Guppy's Paw. Now we're going to go back and grab the Book of Revelations. Now, I like the coupon. Don't get me wrong. I do like the coupon. I think it is a pretty good item. It's just not what I want right now. I feel like we kind of have to do this. Oh, man. We get Steven and Tapeworm. Both huge upgrades for us. I don't mind being greedy here with this cube of meat damage. We have Virgo. If we're going to get hit, at least we can allow us... We can proc whenever we get hit. Thanks to, you know, us being a little bit greedy there. And you saw how much damage cube of meat does. The reason why, by the way, we got a horseman was because of the fact that we did use Book of Revelations, which is guaranteed to give you a horseman on every odd number floor. I think it's every odd, or it's maybe every even, I'm not sure. But Steven, of course, gives us a huge raw damage upgrade. And now we can re-roll the coupon here, and we get Judas's Shadow! Ooh boy, okay. So now we've got ourselves quite the fun time here. So Judas's Shadow, we have to kill ourselves here. We don't have to, but I'm going to. I'm going to kill Isaac so we can return as Black Judas. And what that's going to do is that's going to give us a huge damage multiplier. And on top of that, we're also going to have a movement speed. We're going to have a movement speed boost thanks to the blood bag. And then sticking with the Book of Revelations here will also give us a way to quickly recover our HP that we lose. So, and if you think that this is silly, that I'm throwing away all this HP, you may not necessarily be wrong. But I would argue that I would much rather be Black Judas and get the damage multiplier than not. You know what I mean? Like being Black Judas and having 3 HP is a lot better than not being Black Judas with 12 HP, in my opinion. This is a very aggressive play, though, so I don't recommend doing this unless you know what you're doing. There we go. So we are now Black Judas. And as you see there, we don't start with a lot of HP, but we are going to go grab this. It's going to give us our movement speed upgrade, which is awesome. And yeah, now have a huge amount of damage. Again, our damage is going to go up here with Rotten Baby as well. Oh, goodness. Isaac. I hate I Found Pills that it screws you up like that. Yeah, you know what? That's fine. We look metal. Super scary. I guess I'll take it. Tapeworm, of course, is going to give us a huge amount of shot speed as well, which is nice. Head on down. We've got ourselves a pretty nice run now. Just because of one item. That's what I love about Isaac. You're only one item away from getting a huge leg up on the competition. So we get Curse of the XL, which I'm not happy about, but it makes me feel even better that we got Black Judas. That was a big time get out of the out of that boss trap room. I wasn't even planning on going in there, to be quite honest. Is it me or that one? Yeah, that one's completely invisible. There we go. So, see what's inside of this dice room here. I will not be rerolling. But Forget Me Now, which can be actually pretty good because this is Curse of the XL, we'll be able to do. If we can get a way out, we need a teleportation card to get out of the boss fight. If we can somehow swing that, then we'd be able to possibly get an extra 2 floors out of this Forget Me Now. Thank you. And again, you see there, we have one-shottable damage here with our Rotten Baby Flies. Gonna keep on using our Book of Revelations just to build up our HP. A very odd place and a very inconvenient place for the super secret room to spawn. Way the heck down there. bad damage there. I really don't know why I'm using Cuban meat like this. We don't have to. Buck up. Go ahead and take that. I'm drowsy. Go ahead and use that. I think I'm drowsy. I believe that that's basically just the stopwatch effect. I think. Again, I'm not one who takes pills all the time, so I could be wrong about that. Go grab another key. Again, you see how powerful it is having Transcendence here. That really helped us out. Also a very inconvenient spot for the other item room, by the way. Game. Just saying. I will save our bomb here. We'll use the key to go around. Again, we're looking for a teleportation card because we want to be able to get... I want to be able to do the mom fight. We're not going to make boss rush, but do the mom fight, get a deal with the devil, and then teleport our way out of there via, you know, whatever card we can find. Tinted rock here. Small rock would be awesome. Any damage up that we get is going to be huge, huge amounts of damage because of the fact we are Black Judas. We have that built-in damage multiplier, which is fantastic. We get the miter as well. Good to see a miter. Man, this run is just getting... We're getting snowball-y really quickly here. The miter will make any naturally spawning red hearts turn into soul hearts, which is very good. Especially if we're going to be getting rid of our Red Heart HP on this floor. Being Black Judas, there we go. We are energy. Oh man, that's so good for the Book of Revelations. 48-hour energy. There we go. We are now in probably one-run territory. I don't think there's any way that we can lose this run. We have so many things going right for us right now. I didn't want to do that room because I didn't feel like messing with the hosts, but at least these weren't jumpers. They're not leapers or the Fat Isaacs. Leaping Fat Isaacs, I mean. Hermit car, that's all we needed right there. So we are going to be able to do the mom fight, both boss fights, and hopefully get a deal with the devil. Then we can port on out of there with the hermit card and go and just do this floor again, possibly even get an extra floor out of this. Because of the forget-me-now, so... And this is also equally good because we got a greed fight inside of our last shop, which kind of screws us out of a possible, you know, another good item here. I am somewhat motivated to go see our super secret room because we have found one Guppy item. Super secret rooms aren't traditionally the best in Afterbirth Plus especially, but never know. Alright. Alright, then we have the long, 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 long way to get to next item room and the cursed room as well. But yeah, I mean, this is, it's a one run. Let's not be silly here. We've got a way of getting our HP, barring some sort of weird Curse of the Blind happening, or me just going brain dead in the middle of the run, which is possible, by the way. I don't see any possible way that we can lose this run. It is almost inconceivable. Guarding his humanity, you don't really need it. Now this definitely would have been a floor for us to get Mama Mega on. That would have been nice. And if we get, I'll tell you this much, if we end up getting a better Tears rate or something along those lines, definitely could see us doing a full clear of the void. And fighting Delirium. I know it's been a while since you all have seen me fight Delirium. And doing it on this run would make sense, but I would need to get a little bit more damage in the form of, like, you know, if we get Death's Touch, we're basically Death's Touch away from me considering that, seriously. Butt bombs, I'm only taking it just for the five bombs, you know, fight war. It's a horseman. Again, we knew it was going to be a horseman because we had the Book of Revelations. You see there, we have the sparkly butt bombs because of the fact we have Glitter bombs. Pheromones, one that makes you small. Get the second level cube of meat, which is fine. Make sure we do not drop our hermit card. So we're hoping for a deal with the devil, then we're going to use the hermit card to teleport out of here, and then we're just going to do this floor again. Possibly even the other floor as well. So you see how powerful the Virgo shield is. We did not get a deal with the devil, which is almost an insult at this point. But But then you use a hermit card, go back to the shop, and then we got to go all the way around back to the dice room, and we're going to do it again. So a little bit upset that we did not get the deal with the devil. Not that big of a deal. Not that we needed it or anything, but it would have been nice. You know, it would have been nice if you stuck it out for us there one time game. We're going to use the five room and do it all again. There we go. That's one. Look at that. We got two extra rooms out of that. So if you don't know what just happened, this is what happened. On a Curse of the XL, the Curse of the XL stands for extra large, which means that we get two floors for the price of one. Now, what we just did is we basically just we took the forget-me-now and acted like the Curse of the XL never happened. And if we did not get a Curse of the XL like we didn't, we actually start on Depths 1 again, because technically we were on Depths 1. Even though it was an XL floor, it still only contained elements of the first Depths instead of the second one, meaning that the game, in the game's mind, we had started this... We basically took that forget-me-now on Depths 1 instead of Depths 2. And since we did not get Curse of the XL, we now get not only do Depths 2 again, but we also get to redo Depths 1 again. So that worked out very well for us, because now we get two extra floors of extra items, double deal chances, etc. So I realize that play there seemed a little convoluted, and maybe even after the explanation it might be a little bit confusing, but trust me, it was a good play. Don't care about teleport here. Now, if the question comes down to, do we want Book of Revelations over Guppy's Head, I think we definitely stick with Guppy's Head, just because of the sheer amount of damage that we're doing. With a run this good, I don't think I'm going to need the extra HP, let's put it that way. Also, shout out to the game for, again, giving us a greed fight, even after we just got done doing one. That's alright. Not salty about it. Hard to be salty when you've got a Black Judas possible Guppy run in the making. We definitely are motivated to get rid of our red hearts. Really care about the counterfeit penny. Just doing this to save time here. Say thank you to the Book of Revelations. It's been an honor and a privilege. We should actually go check out the Mob Trap room, just in case there's a Guppy item in there. Only one Guppy item away. If it's three red chests, I'll do it. If it's not, if it's anything but that, I'm not going to do it. Yeah. So, and the reason why I say that is because we have a greater chance of getting a Guppy item out of three red chests than, like, a steel chest, which has a 0% chance. Oh, that works. Definitely want a little bit more bombs. Slightly more movement speed would be nice, but not really needed. But it would be nice. It'd make me feel a little bit better. We're definitely going to go fight the lamb on this fight, for sure. But I would love to be able to go fight a little bit more tiers rate. 10 tiers rate's not bad, but it's not great. But if we do the lamb, though, I'm going to have to think really hard if I actually don't want the Book of Revelations. It sort of kind of depends on this next devil deal that we get, if we get one. Wow, I did not even see that shadow. Getting something like the wafer would be awesome. Not get a deal with the devil, we're going to go get meat. We're just going to head on down and say thank you to the Book of Revelations. Meat's going to give us damage and HP. Let's see if we can do something about Isaac's face here. Well, he was sparkling. I need to see the sparkles, though, Isaac. Alright, that's good enough. He looks scary enough. Yeah, so hopefully we get, if we're able to teleport out of the mom fight this time around, that'd be awesome. I definitely am thinking about going and just doing the lamb right now. We could definitely do it, as long as we don't lose too much HP, you know, using the sack room and whatnot. I would still love a chance, at least, to see if we can actually get Guppy. We get Euthanasia, by the way, which has been showing up quite often recently. I'm A-okay with. Remember, we have Steam Sales, so Steam Sales is going to give us a little bit of a cheaper item. Go with our ridiculous amount of buying power right now. the IV bag. Don't really care about the IV bag. I do want to see what's inside the boss trap room. Golden chest, not really interested. Now, going to the dark chest also provides us with a very good opportunity to get Guppy because of all the red chests that spawn down there. Get the D1. D1's not bad, but I'd rather have the Guppy's head. D1 basically rerolls stuff that's on the ground. One of the random things on the ground, it will duplicate or reroll. So if we get enough turned in, I might actually take the D1 because I can go buy a backpack and then we can just use. It's a shame that I didn't have backpack before we got rid of the Book of Revelations. Man, it's thundering like crazy outside. Hopefully I don't lose power during this. That would be the real kicker. We have this really great run and then we end up losing power. That'd be some Victor luck. I do want to check out the cursed room. But I think that I'm just going to, if we don't get ported to the devil deal, or we don't get a teleportation card, I think I might just go straight to the lamb. Especially now that it's super stormy outside. Hoping that one of these is a teleportation card. And it is. Alright. Good, good, good. So we've got a good shot here becoming Guppy. We just need one more. Slight misplay there. I forgot that we had Guppy's head. I don't usually take the backpack. Pay to win. A little bit late for that, unfortunately. Get Infamy. Happily take that. And definitely need this fool card. There we go. I'm going to fight Mom again. I guess I ran into her before. Yeah. Not going to deal with the devil again, man. Alright, game. Whatever you say. Here we go. We're going to go right on in here. And we're going to do the sack room. I might be making a huge mistake. I also might be completely overestimating my survivability right now. We do gain some soul hearts out of this, by the way. Starting to really rethink this. This doesn't seem like it was a great decision here. That would have been... I don't want to give up on it yet, but that would have been better had I just had the Book of Revelations. I kind of really overestimated the amount of survivability we would have if I did that. Was there a soul heart inside of the store? Because we're only like two taps away from getting teleported. But even if we get teleported, then it's kind of like, well, we don't have a whole lot of HP. I mean, we got a good run going here, but I don't want to dunk the streak like this, you know. There is a soul heart in here. I don't want to ruin this streak, but at the same time, I definitely want to give you guys, gals, what I promised. Oh, yeah. There is Uriel, or Sacriel. Gabriel, not Sacriel. Oh, boy. I don't know. I don't know if we're going to be able to do it here. I will go down to the dark chest to fight the lamb. But with the amount of HP that I've given away here, I thought for sure that we'd be ported there by now. May not do this. I think that more people would be upset if I lost the streak this way rather than just me saying, yeah, we'll go do it, but not right now. Stars card, yeah. All right, well, sorry to waste everyone's time on that. I promise you I will go fight the lamb on this run. But I gave away a lot more HP there than I was really intending on. I'm also still pretty offended that we did not get a double deal game. Feel like we should have gotten one, but head on down the next floor. Apparently the game was not in a giving mood because we did four floors there without getting a deal with the devil, so there's that. Oh, we get Bookworm out of this, which I will take. And Emperor card could be nice. We're gonna hold on to the Emperor card for the Lamb. This is gonna be a very interesting, very, very, very interesting run. I'll show you what the D1 does real quick. Basically just duplicates that. And yes, by the way, I do realize that I could have taken the D1 and duplicated some of the soul hearts on the ground. I know. I could have done that, but I didn't. Almost pressed the wrong button there because I was facing the wrong way. Right now, my focus is on making sure that we rebuild our HP before we go fight the Lamb. Never do that again, game. Bombs are key. I mean, we're not actually going to need that many keys. I am going to use this. Bombs are actually going to be a little bit more important, I think. A little bit sad that we have not gotten any soul hearts yet. Extended rocks or anything like that. A little bit nervous, not gonna lie. There's one. Two, actually. I kind of wish I would have duplicated that chest, but that's okay. Lots of pills here. Probably nothing to care about. Balls of steel. And speed up as well. Okay. This is getting good. Because now, if we find something that's worth duplicating, with the D1... we can use all those 48-hour energy pills to create what is essentially a ton of HP for ourselves. So I'm going to go back and see if we can get a Tenant Rock. All we need is one. Really, all we need is one Soul Heart on the ground. That's all we want. One Soul Heart on the ground gets us our path to victory here. I realize that's asking for a lot, game. Sun card. Go use that so I don't get my Emperor card. I realize you might think that this is a bunch of needless backtracking here, which it might very well be, but it's going to pay off if we end up finding ourselves a soul heart and being able to copy either the chest or the soul heart on the ground with all those 48-hour energy pills that we've got. And with us having Mitre, our chance of getting a Soul Heart is a lot higher than usual. And then we get Small Rock. Gives us a much-needed Tears Up, and damn it, well, we don't really need damage, but... the one time we didn't even need Small Rock to show up, it shows up, of course. Really hate those Chub Mobs. I think it would be wise to use the D1 inside of the cursed room if there is a red chest in there. There is a Tenant Rock here. So this might be it. There we go. Now I'm going to walk out and walk back in because I do not want to duplicate the empty chest. There we go. So now we're going to go back and go grab the pills. Those 48-hour energy pills that we have. And hopefully this will give you a little bit of a newfound appreciation for the D100, for the D1 as well. I'm not going to do this for all of this. In fact, I'm just going to duplicate it once just to show you all. But if I didn't care about time, I would go back and use every single one of these pills. But I don't think we need it at this point. So 40-hour energy, going to go ahead and do that first, and then I'll bring another one down. And this will give us 3 extra soul hearts that we can use and collect right now. Do we need to do this? Nah, probably not. But again, I do feel like I could show you all a thing or two. It might open your eyes to some items you normally wouldn't even care about, like the D1, for example. I'm going to go all the way back over here and then use our D1. That. We're going to do it again and again. There we go. Just like that, we are at full HP. Pretty darn neat, huh? Butterbean, even if it's, I can't believe it's not Butterbean, I don't care. No Guppy, unfortunately. That's okay. Not going to be greedy here. We've already... We got what we asked for. We got our... We basically got our Soul Heart on the ground that we wanted. Again, if I wanted to really min-max, I could just simply go and duplicate it over and over again, but I don't care about that. It is thundering like crazy outside, which is actually going to make me speed up this run a little bit, because I really want to get this run recorded and not have it have the power go out. And, of course, it's going to be the one boss that takes the longest, and it's even better. It's Black Champion Skolex. Did get a lot of damage there with Cuban Meat, however. Get Latch Key. It's going to give us keys and a Soul Heart and Luck Up. And we get Brimstone and a Thane, which I will happily take both. Yeah, Brimstone, Black Judas, we're good to go, fam. Mathis would say. Small, sure, why not? So, and yes, Bookworm does affect Brimstone. You'll get the 20-20 effect when you shoot your Brimstone. Now, this would all be capped off by if we ended up getting Guppy as well. That would be pretty darn nice. But I think it's safe to say here now, obviously, this has been a one run for a while. Hoping when we get a Soul Heart there that I can duplicate with the D1. Not that big of a deal. Yeah, we really don't need a whole lot of keys or anything at this point, because we're going to be going to the Lamb, and we don't need keys for red chests. Go on that, and not see Attendant Rock, that's okay. There you go, we three-shot Mom's Heart. And we get the Mark and a Betrayal. I will take the Mark, just because it only costs us 2 Soul Hearts. And we're going to head on down to go see Stanley. Right. Alternate boss killing is aplenty this week, apparently. All right, now this is a golden opportunity for us. I hope that we get Soul Hearts or an item out of this red chest here. So let's find out if it is indeed something we want. Pills, bombs are key. Makes you small, so no. The answer is no. Oh, that's actually turned into spiders. Okay, so unlike the Yara rune... the D1 actually does not copy the contents of the chests. That's actually really interesting to know. I did not know that. I thought that the D1, much like the Yara runes, also... Excuse me. Oh, those just fire, okay. There we go, we get a free Soul Heart here, which I will happily do. Duplicated the open chest. Oh, well, it's alright. Never mind. Apology accepted, game. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you, Mitre, by the way. They count the 3-1000 here, drop a bomb, and you will take down the bomb lampreys that spawn right there. And usually you'll push Fallen over the edge as well. Yeah. The amount of damage that we get out of a Thane if we end up taking damage is absurd. Thanks to us being Black Judas. There we go. We're going to head on down to the Lamb. We could do Delirium as well. I don't really want to, though. Again, it is starting to really pour outside, so I don't really want to push my luck. I was going to use the Emperor card, and we'll go ahead and get on out of here, because I just saw the power flicker. Alright, well, I hope you all enjoyed this one. It was a lot of fun. Shout out to Juice of Shadow, of course. I think the MVP definitely has to go to Rotten Baby. Rotten Baby did work for us. I mean, it was great. It was a nice shot there by, nice block there by Infamy. Oh, yeah. Power's definitely going out here. No, not right now. Now is not the time. Thank you for watching, everyone. I'm going to stop this video before power goes out. Until next time, so long, everybody.